I've day gamed and coached guys in many cities in Europe and North America, and in this video I'll tell you the easiest and the hardest cities for learning day game. Hi, I'm Central Albert, and for the last 2 years I've been coaching day game in very different cities. I've worked with guys from the US, Canada, Australia, Hong Kong, Israel, all over EU, Switzerland, UK, etc. And now I have a pretty good grasp on how easy or hard it is to learn day game in very different locations. If you're new to my YouTube channel, and instead of long conversations about meditation, inner game, 14 different ways to become more alpha, or how to become a natural and other nonsense and mental masturbation, you prefer a very technical step-by-step approach to day game, then subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's start with talking what is actually considered an easy day game city and why it isn't necessarily a good idea for everyone to learn in the easiest cities for day game. I consider a city easy for day game if girls are open to being approached on the streets there. So it means when you stop them, they actually stop and they respond to your stacks, and it will be easy to carry on a conversation with them. In cities like that, the biggest pro is, well, since they're open to day game and you don't get as many blowouts, you don't only get to practice the stop, but you can actually practice your opening, your stacking, your storytelling, all this back and forth vibing thing, challenging, qualification, closing strong, so all parts of the set. And the biggest con is, well, if you learn in an easier city for day game, your stop doesn't have to be that strong to succeed. Your stacking doesn't have to be amazing to succeed. So you'll still have many leaks in your game if you learn in a city that's easy for day game. Well, in the harder cities, it's pretty simple. You'll get a lot of blowouts. They will leave straight after stacks. They will not open up. These conversations will be short. Numbers will be flaky. And you'll need a really, really tight game to get the numbers, then get them to come on dates, and then get them to sleep with you. But the biggest pro of learning day game in a place like that is, if you learn and succeed in a city like that, then going to any other city will seem like a walk in a park. Easy training, hard wars, hard training, easy wars. And now let's talk about the easiest and the hardest cities for day game. One thing worth mentioning though is, this is my opinion, this is my experience and the experience of my students in these cities. The more I day game, the more I travel, the more my impressions will change, and maybe I'll make a new video a year from now. So, three easiest cities to learn day game in. They're great for day game trips, they're great if you're living there, you can go there for coaching, or if you go on a trip there solo, then make sure you have at least 10 day game lays in a city where you're actually learning day game right now. Number one on the list, as probably you expected, is Prague in Czech Republic. Prague has beautiful local girls, but it also attracts tourists from all over the world, and it has very many Russian solo travelers. I've had great adventures in Prague. I wrote 3 blog posts about 3 consecutive days in Prague. First one was about how I pulled home a hot international model who's originally from Czech Republic. The second evening was a same day lay with a solo Russian traveler, 18 years old, her first solo trip from Russia, just came to Prague. And the third day was a first date lay with a Russian girl who lives in Prague, who was very shy, but turned out to be crazy into BDSM and a very, very submissive girl. And another funny story from Prague was when I was coaching a student of mine there, and on the second day of coaching, he went on an instant date with a girl from UK. And while he's talking to her in the set, he says, "Hey, let's go for a coffee. I know this really cool place right around the corner." And he's leading, he's going, but he doesn't actually know a cool coffee place. He's just leading. And he walks in the first bar and they go in, they sit down. And only when they sit down, he realizes he accidentally took that girl to Hooters. But after having one drink at Hooters, he went to a nice cocktail bar where I was sitting at the bar while he was with the girl at the table. I was at the bar listening to their date, sending him instructions about do this, touch her like this, talk about this subject. And at one point I text him, "She's ready, you have to pull home, do you have condoms?" Turns out the student didn't have condoms on him, didn't have condoms in his apartment, so I had to go to a corner store, buy condoms, give him condoms so he could go and pull his date home and get a same day lay in Prague. Most of these stories have actually been on my blog or on my YouTube videos, so just head over to my website saintrobert.blog and search for Prague if you want to read more about them. I have to say, Prague is one of my favorite, if not the favorite city for coaching day game, because The girls are open to day game. They have so many tourists, so many people from all over the world. The vibe is great. It's a beautiful city. It's fairly cheap. I love it. If you haven't been on a day game trip and you're looking for a first place to go to Prague. The next on the list is Poland. There are several cities you can go to, but I've been to Krakow, but Warsaw is really good too. It's full with beautiful local girls, young students, and also it's full with foreign students from Russia, Belarus, Ukraine, so you got those hot Eastern Europeans too. One thing to keep in mind about Poland though, a lot of the students in the bigger cities are actually from smaller towns and villages, so they usually leave those big cities on Fridays and come back on Sundays. So keep that in mind if you want to take a shorter trip there. Poland is not typically a first date lay country, but you can expect to get laid on a second date if your game is decent, and sometimes on a first date as well. We've had some great adventures in Krakow, Poland. I was staying there with actually the first international student I ever had. We were staying in a two-bedroom Airbnb and he decided to pull the naked man on his chick. The chick went to the bathroom, she comes back and this guy is sitting without the pants with his dick out and just tried the move. Well, it didn't work, but it's a great fucking story. Krakow is also the city where the term doing the Frank was involved. Frank, a student of mine, took a girl on a date and fingered her under a table in a bar. So since that time in our group chat, we have the move called the Frank. And the third on the list is my hometown, the place where I learned day game, Riga in Latvia, that's in Baltics. And it's a great city for day game with some very nice girls, and it's not that hard to get results there, and especially if you're day gaming Latvian girls instead of Russian girls living there. A lot of guys sooner or later go on a day game trip to Baltic cities, so it's in Lithuania, Estonia or Latvia. And most commonly they go to Lithuania or Estonia, not a lot of guys go to Riga in Latvia. And that is a mistake because I know several guys from Vilnius, I know several guys from Tallinn, and they've day gamed in Riga as well, and they agree that Riga is actually better for day game. It's the girls are more beautiful and they're kind of, it's higher traffic, so it's easier to get your sets in. So if you've been to Prague, if you've been to some places in Poland, then go to Riga next. And a little extra when it comes to good day game cities. Well, I'm recording this video from Playa del Carmen, Mexico. So cities like Playa del Carmen and other places where a lot of tourists go and when there is a large number of nomads and expats living, well, they're usually pretty good for day game too. We came to Playa del Carmen with a bunch of other day gamers, and after spending a month here, we recorded a podcast about day game here. So if you want to hear more about Playa del Carmen and day game here, then listen to the podcast episode number 65. And now before we move to the hardest cities for day game, I think one city really worth mentioning is Budapest in Hungary. Girls there are petite, they're beautiful, they have tits, they have asses, everything you would want for. But I had the feeling the city is kind of relationship oriented. They've had a lot of day gamers going there, so the day game isn't as easy there. So Budapest, in my opinion, is like something between the easy cities and harder cities. If you've been to the easier day game cities, then before moving to the harder ones, give Budapest a try. And now let's talk about the hardest cities for learning day game I've been to. If you're a beginner or intermediate day gamer, if you have less than 30 day game lays, don't fucking go there. You'll get your ass handed to you. If you have less than 30 day game lays, I only suggest going to the hard cities for day game if you're signing up for a day game bootcamp with me. Seriously, forget about going there solo just for a few days. Of course, you can get laid in any place in the world in just in a few days, but the less time you spend in a harder city for day game, the more you have to rely on luck, and you don't really want to rely on luck when you're going on a day game trip. Number one on my list is Belgrade in Serbia. Some of the hottest girls I've seen in the world. You know how Russians have those beautiful cheekbones, stunning model faces, tall, beautiful legs? There's one thing Russians don't have. Well, two things, tits and asses. Well, in Serbia, you have the same Russian hotness, but with tits and asses, it's incredible. At the same time, getting 8 harsh blowouts in a row is fairly typical. Some of the blowouts are they don't even look at you and walk around you as if you didn't exist, as if you were a fucking street dog. While it's different with tourists, don't expect to get first or second date lays with the hot locals. Serbia is a fairly traditional country, even in Belgrade, and you will most likely have to go on several dates if you wanna sleep with the beautiful local girls. That being said, I spent some time with Frank there and he lost his wristwatch after fingering a girl outdoors in public next to the Belgrade fortress. So you can also have wild adventures there. The second on the list of hardest cities to learn day game in is New York City. Any type of a girl that you like, you can find them in New York City. The tall, Russian looking model type, you got them. Classy business ladies, you got them. Hipsters, tattooed girls, whatever is your thing, you can find them in New York City. And dating in New York City is fast. Most likely you will either get laid on the first date or you're not gonna get laid with that girl. The biggest thing I can tell about New York City after day gaming there and coaching several students there is you need a very, very strong day game stop. If your day game stop is weak, they will often simply walk around you because they're busy, they're running somewhere, they're not in the mood to chat to some random guy on the street. But if your day game stop is strong and your day game is strong, then that city is incredible. The hotness of girls there is really fucking good, whatever is your type. New York City is actually one of the cities that taught me the importance of strong day game stop and inspired me to make the video about top 3 day game stop mistakes. So watch that video if you want to improve your day game stop. And the third on the list is a small city in Europe that I went to just hang out with some friends and day game there and see how it is. And I really didn't like it. It was Antwerp, Belgium. Well, the city is beautiful, beer is good, girls are actually pretty beautiful. But at the same time, it's kind of like a strong, independent woman slash feminist vibe. And I prefer feminine girls. That's why I'm so attracted to Russians and other place and other girls from the Eastern Europe. Still, even though it's pretty hard to dig in there, I know guys that were struggling there for a long time, but then they fixed leaks in their games and started getting results even in a city like that. So now that you know the easiest and the hardest cities for learning day game, well, if you're going on a day game trip, where should you go? If you're going solo, start with easier cities like Prague in Czech Republic or Krakow or Warsaw in Poland. If you've done those, level up to Budapest. Test your dating skills in a city that's a little bit harder. And then once you have 30 or more day game lays, hit the hard cities. If you are from the United States, go to New York City, test your skills there. And if you're in Europe, then go to some places in Balkans, Serbia, or there are many other cities in Balkans worth going to. But that is about solo travels. If you're going there with me to get coaching, then send me a message and tell me your story. And I'll actually suggest which cities might be better for you, because some guys need to learn in easier cities. While if you have strong frame and strong mental game and you can deal with rejections very well, maybe you're better off learning in a tougher place like Serbia or New York City. Whenever I go to a new city, I usually, after spending a month there, just record a podcast about where should you day game there, what to expect there, what types of girls are there, in what ways you have to adjust your game. So if there is a city you want to go to from the ones I mentioned, just search for the city name on my blog and you'll probably find a podcast of me talking about that city. And I've day gamed in all of those cities and I coach day game in most of those cities. So if you want to get coaching in any of those cities, then just head over to my website and on the top menu, click day game coaching to learn more about it. If you like this video and you want to see more technical step-by-step videos about learning day game, then subscribe to my YouTube channel.